We are at Upper Hill area of Nairobi. Now, this is the steam engine train. It's going to take us through our excursion. Now, on this other side, excited passengers now taking pictures to remember this historic event before we embark on our journey.
As soon as everyone was on board, it was time to embark on the trip to the river. This 55 years old engine, which had stopped being used in the late 70s, once again roared to life. Crude oil is used to produce the energy which heats the water in these tanks and thrusts the locomotive into action. These men with expertise spanning decades, and all of them whom had retired after the close of the use of steam engine locomotives, were once again at work, carefully guiding the machine through the rails.
Sasa hii ni mwaka yangu ya 12 tangu ni retire. Lakini kwa kuwa hakuna watu wengine niliitwa nije kuendesha hii gari. Kwa kuna hakuna watu wamekuwa train.
Inside the coaches, the voice of artist Linda Mudhama punctuated the roaring of the train as enthusiastic passengers danced to the tune. Lunch was also served on board in a surrounding that further boosted appetites here. Kenya is the second country in Africa which is still using these locomotive engines, courtesy of an enterprising Kenyan, Francis Wawero, who has partnered with Rift Valley Railways and Kenya Railways.
We could at least show this generation and the generations after what the mode of transport for Kenyans was earlier on.
The trip costs each adult 1,700 shillings, while children are charged 1,300 shillings each.
I feel like I'm living in the past. Those things that used to be there and I was not there, I am part of it. I feel like I own the past, yet I'm in the future.
This steam engine locomotive produces more smoke and thus pollutes the environment more than the diesel locomotive, but apparently it is easier to maintain.
Franklin Macharia, Sunday Live.